Imagine a beautiful outdoor space. Is it a lush green lawn or a perfectly manicured garden? These landscapes are pretty, but they're not necessarily healthy. They don't actually do much for us or for the wildlife that depend on them.
I think gardens are part of an old world, and I think we need to build a new one.
Healthy ecosystems are communities of diverse plants and animals working together in balance. And around the world, people are finding ways to restore that balance. The key is native plants, the ones that have grown naturally in our ecosystems for thousands of years and still can, if we let them. Here in Ireland, Mary Reynolds is bringing back native plants through a movement called We Are the Ark.
We need to learn how to share. If you can take half of your land and restore a native plant community, that would be massive.
Native plant species offer food and shelter to wildlife, recycle nutrients, and revitalize the soil. And people everywhere are discovering how native plants can be a simple, powerful way to restore the natural world. A lot of our farmland used to be prairie. Coastal cities used to be wetlands and forests. And we can restore these ecosystems if we make the effort. Programs to do just that are sprouting up everywhere. Miami, Florida is a shining example.
I think most people have this idea of Miami being this lush, gorgeous green place, but it's all plants which are not originally from this part of the world. The real Miami, before we started changing it, looked very, very different. The main ecosystem we had was the pine rocklands. We lost about 98% of it.
But today, those native pine rockland forests have an ally. Daniela Champney and the Native Plant Network at Fairchild Tropical Botanic Garden.
The idea is planting it back 1 yard at a time.
Leading the charge is a new generation of native plant champions. With support from Daniela and the Native Plant Network, students at Pine Lake Elementary are turning part of their schoolyard back into a pine rockland.
This space has been kind of a work in progress for about the last 4 years, and the students are the ones who are the truest ambassadors of this.
Here at Pine Lake, restoring habitat means uprooting non-native plants and replanting native species. And having the right tools makes all the difference.
If you want to plant in Miami, you usually use a pickaxe. We don't have nice, rich, soft soil. We have coral rock and some sand. But that's exactly what the pan rockland plants need and want and love.
Whew, we're gonna get our workout here today.
Yeah. From replanting to watering to keeping non-native plants at bay, young people everywhere are making patches of native habitat their own. And the solutions are as diverse as the communities leading them. Back in Ireland, rewilding a schoolyard meant just letting nature take over, no planting required. The transition from well-groomed garden to native plant paradise might take some time. So whatever you call it, a native garden, an ark, a wild patch, it helps to let people know that something special is happening.
We ask people to put up a sign, and it gives them almost like permission to celebrate what they've been doing.
If we really want to bring native plants back, we need a lot of people from the community to participate.
It's, I think, so important to connect kids from a young age to what is here, what was here, what can be here again.
It doesn't take much to go back to becoming guardians instead of gardeners.
By embracing native plants, we can give local habitats a chance to recover and thrive. So let's reimagine what nature can be in our communities and work together to restore ecosystems that our native plants and wildlife can call home.